Because of who you are, I give you glory.
Sing to him, sing loud.
Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are.
Sing that again. Because of who you are, I give you glory.
Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are my Father, my provider, my deliverer. Lord, you reign in victory. Wonderful Counselor, my Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are. You are my Father, my Provider, my Deliverer. Lord, you reign in victory. Wonderful Counselor, my Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are. And I worship you because of who you are. And I worship you because of who. Crown him King of Kings.
Lift your hands to him and sing crown.
Crown him Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful Counselor, the mighty God. Emmanuel, God is with. He shall reign forever.
Oh, sing from your heart. Crown him King of Kings.
Crown him King of Kings. Crown him Lord of Lords. Wonderful Counselor, the mighty God. God is with us, and he shall reign.
Let him reign.
He shall reign. He shall reign forevermore. Emmanuel, God is with us, and he shall reign. He shall reign forevermore. He shall reign forevermore.
Praise you, Lord. We're going to sing a song that maybe somewhat new. We've sung it here before, but I just want us to look at the words here. You know, there's a the lives we live are being noticed by those around us. And the chorus says, oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. It's one thing for the Lord to save us and to make us like Jesus, but are there others around us? Are there people around us, our children, our neighbors, our co-workers, our spouses, our relatives, seeing the footprints that we leave, just like Jesus left His footprints, that will lead them also to believe in the lives that we live? Inspire them to obey. This is what I want. I want others around me who see my obedience to be inspired to obey themselves. And it's a good thing for us to think about as we reach the end of another year. Have I lived in such a way that others around me are inspired to follow Jesus more wholeheartedly? We're pilgrims on the journey of the narrow road. And those who've gone before us line the way, cheering on the faithful,
yes, encouraging,
encouraging the weary, their lives a stirring testament to God's sustaining grace. Surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us run the race not only for the prize, but as those who've gone before us, let us lead to those behind us the heritage of faithfulness passed on through godly lives. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light the way. Footprints that we leave, lead them to believe, and the lives we live, inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. After all our hopes and dreams have come and gone, our children sift through all we've left behind. May the clues that they
help us, Lord,
make it so, and the memories they uncover become the light that leads them to the road we each must find. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light the way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light the way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey.
Can we sing it again? Oh, may all who come,
oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light the way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe.
Yes, Lord.
And the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
Can we pray for a few minutes together? Is this the cry of your heart as well? The Lord would do something. He's left us here as His church, a living expression of the body of Christ, not just waiting for Him to take us home to heaven, but to take as many with us as we can, to touch even one more life this week if we can. Not out of burden, not out of guilt, but because God has poured out His love within us, shed abroad His love in our hearts. Pray with me, family. It's your prayer that the Lord wants to hear. Thank you, Father. We exalt you and praise you. Give you all the glory and honor. You're worthy of praise. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for making a way of salvation, Lord, that included me. Unworthy as I am, even now, Lord, unworthy. Thank you for including me in your plan of salvation, for bridging that gap as wide as it was, as deep as the pit that I was in. You bridged it, Lord. You came down, picked me up, and you've set my feet on a rock. And I will trust you, Lord. I will choose to believe in your goodness all the days of my life because you have been good. You can't not be good. You can't not be full of love. And you are faithful even when I am finding myself without faith. I praise you. We praise you, Lord, for your goodness and your greatness, your faithfulness. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We exalt you. And I pray, Lord, even like we just sang, that we live lives that are on fire for you, that the fire of our devotion will spread to others around us, Lord. You've placed us in this world. You've left us here on this earth that we might touch one more life, that passion for you will burn so brightly, Lord, even if we don't have gifts in speaking or other gifts, Lord, but that our lives, the fire of your Holy Spirit burning within us, will touch one more life, that will touch one more child perhaps today and perhaps this week. Do it so, Lord, that this coming year will be another year of devotion for you alone. Burn us up. Burn up all of flesh, all of self, all pride, all self-seeking, all bitterness, all complaining and grumbling, Lord. Dissatisfaction, jealousy, covetousness, lust. Burn it all up, Lord, that we can be fully yours, that you can flow through us and change the world, turn the world right side up like you did with the early church. That's our prayer, Lord. Use us, small as we may be, insignificant. We seek no glory here on this earth. We don't want to be known here on this earth. We want to be known in heaven. And we want to be known in hell where Satan is afraid of us because we're a church that's surrendered to you fully. Our marriages are surrendered to you fully. Our homes are surrendered to you fully. Raise us up, Lord. Lift us up higher. We hear your spirit saying, come. Come up higher. And so we want to come up higher in 2023. Not just next year, Lord, but even today, we want to come up higher. We're not waiting for January 1st. You have a miracle that you want to do in our lives today. A changing that you want to do in our lives today. Do it, Lord. And so we stand against Satan. In the name of Jesus, we bind your work, Satan, and resist you because you are a defeated enemy. Thank you, Lord, that you've defeated him. And I pray for any who are bound spiritually in any way, any bad habits, addictions, Lord, besetting sins, hindrances that hinder us from running after you. I pray for any who are bound that way. Set them free in the name of Jesus. Release them, Lord. You said that we could loose on this earth and it would be loosed in the heavens. We could bind the work of Satan here on this earth and it would be bound. So we do that. We loose every marriage, loose every home where there's faith, where there's a hunger for more of your life, more of your abundant life. We praise you and exalt you. Lord Jesus, I pray that our marriages will be even more glorious. Our children will be even more glorious, glorifying to you. Our homes will be pleasing to you. And this church will be even more pleasing to you in the year to come, Lord. That's the only desire we have. Thank you. You will fulfill it. Pray for our material needs, for our physical needs. Thank you that we pray for any who are sick and some who are in our midst, not here today because they're sick. Touch them, heal them, Lord. Lay your hands on them. We know we are not guaranteed it, Lord. Our bodies are decaying. We know that. And our inner man is being strengthened. But we ask, if it is your will, that you will heal those who are sick so that our bodies may be even more for you and healthy for you. Thank you. We exalt you and glorify you. Pray for our jobs. Thank you that you've given us job situations for financial needs any might have. Provide for them, Lord Jesus. Help us to be kind to others. Help us to be a giving people. Help us to be generous, mindful of the needs around us that we can help in whatever way you call us to help. Thank you. And establish your church, Lord. Build your church and build it in such a way that the gates of hell will not prevail against us. Take us to those gates this week, Lord, wherever it might be. Take us to the gates of hell in any person that we encounter this week, that we might tear them down and set people who have been bound by Satan. You did that when you were here on this earth. You've given us the same spirit, Lord, within us. And you've called us to be as you were here on this earth. Help us, and we believe you will. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Hasn't he been faithful? He has been faithful. Let's sing this song. Maybe new to some of you, a wonderful song. All my life, he has been faithful. I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me all my days. I've been held in your hand. He has held you every day. The moment that I wake up, till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Will you? Let's sing that verse again. I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me all my days.
have been held in your hand.
Unworthy as I am, thank you.
From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Sing from your heart all my life.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire and darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have,
yes, I have,
in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Yes, all my life you have been faithful.
All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Oh, he will run after you.
Your goodness is running after,
is running after me.
Your goodness is running after,
is running after me.
With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. All my life you have been faithful.
Sing to him. He's been faithful.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Yes, I will sing.
I will sing of the goodness of God.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning.
Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
All I have needed,
all I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord.
Sing that last verse, pardon for sin and a peace that endureth.
Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. near and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow.
Oh, lift your head up and sing.
Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness.
Yes, great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
He's a good, good shepherd. And so we need not fear anything. Let me read the words of this next song. From the love of my own comfort. The last line says, deliver me, Lord. Deliver me from the love of my own comfort. Deliver me from the fear of having nothing. Deliver me from a life of worldly passions. Deliver me from the need to be understood. Deliver me from the need to be accepted. These are the things the world seeks. This is the source of insecurity in the world. Deliver me from the fear of being lonely. Deliver me from the fear of serving others. Deliver me from the fear of death or trial. Deliver me from the false fear of humility. What will happen if I'm humble? Deliver me, O Father. And I shall not want. When I taste your goodness, I shall not want. I shall have no want. From the fear of my own comfort.
From the fear of having nothing. From a life of worldly passions. Deliver me,
oh, will you pray this?
Oh God, from the need to be understood. From the need to be accepted. From the fear of being lonely. Deliver me, oh God. Deliver me, oh God. And I shall not want, no, I shall not want. When I taste your goodness, I shall not want. Your goodness, I shall not want. From the fear of serving others, from the fear of death or trial, from the fear of humility. I shall not want. When I taste your goodness, I shall not want. When I taste your goodness, I shall not want. And I shall not want. No, I shall not want. When I taste your goodness, shall not want. When I taste your goodness, I shall not want.
Okay, we'll sing one more song. It's another old hymn. We actually do know the author. We'll put it up on their screen next time. It's an old Salvation Army hymn. How quickly life here passes on its way, and you'll soon reach the evening of your day. How quickly life here passes on its way, you soon will reach the evening of your day. Be there for good and tender to each one who journeys with you till life's day is done. Be there for good and tender to each one who journeys with you till life's day is done. The hands that serve you thankfully receive. There enters death and bitterly you grieve. How quickly cometh that unbidden one.
Oh, before it's too late.
Then it's too late to do what is not done. How quickly cometh that unbidden one. Then it's too late. It's not done.
Before we move on, you know what it's talking about here? While you have the opportunity of loved ones around you, people around you to whom you must show appreciation, the hands that have served you, receive them thankfully. Even if it's a grocery store checkout person or somebody else that's serving you in some way here in the church, in your home especially, receive it thankfully and learn to say thanks and express that gratitude to your spouse, to your children, to your parents. Oh, children, that you will learn this at a young age. More and more, there's ungratefulness growing, and that's the source of all kinds of evil and depravity. Learn to say thank you. Learn to be thankful. One day, death will come in, and even the loved ones around you will depart, and it'll be too late then to say thanks. Let's sing verse 3.
While beats the heart, bound close to you in life, of mother, father, children, husband, wife.
Oh, show them love.
Oh, show them love ere they depart from you.
Despite their faults, show them love.
You know yourself what loving deeds can do. Oh, show them love ere they depart from you. Know yourself what loving deeds can do. The feet that tread life's pilgrim way here too, should their stumbling be well known to you.
Even if you see their falls,
oh, take good care not to forget at all how often you yourself didst come to fall. Then take good care not to forget at all how often you yourself didst come to fall. Fault finding, causing other souls to grieve, is easy, but what do you thus achieve? If you can't bear a soul just as he is, then your reward from God you'll surely miss. If you can't bear a soul just as he is, then your reward from God you'll surely miss.
You know what we just sang? Think about how God has accepted us and how he bears with us much more than we ever have to bear with anybody. Think about this in your marriages, husbands and wives. Think about this in your homes with your children, with your siblings. Think about this with your co-workers, with neighbors, other people on the road. If you can't bear a soul just as he is, how can you say you know God who has loved you the way you are, even while you were his enemy?
If you can't bear a soul just as he is, then your reward from God you'll surely miss. If you can't bear a soul just as he is, then your reward from God you'll surely miss. How oft have you God's Holy Spirit grieved, and yet his love so richly you've received? The bonds of love keep strong in all you do. Do unto others as God does to you. The bonds of love keep strong in all you do. Do unto others as God does to you.
Help us, Lord.
The bonds of love keep strong in all you do. Do unto others as God does to you.